So far we've been looking at the biochemistry of macromolecules, but let's talk about where we actually get those macromolecules from, and that's going to be our food. So when I talk about food, that includes our macromolecules, micronutrients, which we only need in very, very small amounts, fiber, and water. So food is going to include all four of these things. Macromolecules. Carbohydrates, we're going to get those from bread, cereals, rice, pasta, fruits, vegetables, milk, corn syrup. Remember that carbohydrates can be both simple sugars and complex carbohydrates. Proteins, we're going to get proteins from fish, meat, beans, eggs, nuts, milk. And those proteins are going to be broken down into their different amino acids, and their body's going to take those amino acids and put them together in the way we need to build our own proteins. Lipids, good sources of lipids, milk, cheese, oil, butter, meat, nuts, and we're going to use those again for energy storage and also to get cholesterol and other important nutrients. I do want to point out, do you notice that there is one particular food that's on all three of these? Yeah, you probably saw. It's milk. Milk is a fantastic food. And think about with mammals, we can survive for up to a year only on mom's milk. And so hopefully it makes sense that it's got a mix of all of these things because even as a baby, you need to get all of those components. I do want to mention that we don't have nucleic acids listed on here, but remember nucleic acids are made of sugars, phosphates, and nitrogen bases. And all of those parts can come from breaking down these other foods, and then they can be built into nucleic acids. Micronutrients. Again, these are nutrients that we need in very, very small amounts. And this includes vitamins. Vitamins are organic substances that the body cannot make. And remember, organic means that it's got carbon in it. Vitamins are going to act as coenzymes and also help in absorbing other foods. Turns out vitamins help move other molecules from that macromolecule section into our cells more efficiently. Minerals are going to be non-organic substances that the body cannot make. This is going to be things like calcium, magnesium, sodium, sulfur that we need. We can take a mineral like calcium and find that it's used in all kinds of different things in our body: nerve impulses, muscle contractions, building bones and teeth. Other kinds of minerals can be used in nucleic acids and in amino acids, so they're going to help build DNA, RNA, and different kinds of proteins. We don't need very many of these, but they are essential, so we do need these small amounts. Fiber is another important part of our food, and fiber are simply complex carbohydrates that we don't have the ability to digest. Sources of fiber include vegetables, fruits, whole grain breads, and pastas. The main source of fiber is the cellulose in plant cell walls. And it turns out that we don't have the enzymes that can actually break down the glucose that are bonded together to build cellulose. And it's funny because we can break down other kinds of glucose, like starches, very easily, but we just don't have the right shaped scissors. Our enzyme doesn't quite fit in there to actually cut that apart. And so instead, it just stays in our small intestine. And it's not a nutrient, but because we can't use it, it helps move feces more quickly through our large intestine. And that's good because there are chemicals that build up there, byproducts from bacteria that are breaking down food, and we want to get that out. And so you hear about a high fiber diet being healthy, and what that's doing is it's just keeping all of the food that's moving through your small intestine moving through. Whole foods versus processed foods. Whole food is food that has almost all of the above parts. So when you eat an apple, it's going to have recognizable macromolecules and micronutrients. But when you eat a Hostess donut, it's going to have fewer of those recognizable parts. And so a processed food is a food that's been refined, and as they're refined, they lose vitamins, minerals, and fiber. And here's a quick overview of that difference between whole and processed foods.